Hello everyone, welcome back to the Temple of Moonlighting, Lamulana. Well, I was going to go back to the Twin Labyrinths, but then I remember something we just unlocked. Way down here. Okay, not that far down.
Well done.
Yeah, when we pressed a little enter pedestal to the top right of here. Yeah, you might notice something is different here.
Hello!
You might also notice we can't actually hurt this guy.
Looks like he can hurt you though.
Yep. I think we should probably go looking for advice. Normally, you'd be wondering quite a bit at this point, but I know exactly where to look for advice. I'm all broke! An enemy that saves life? Does it happen to have a dog-like head? That's probably Anubis. It seems he's the god of the dead. If you had what's known as the Book of the Dead, then it wouldn't be able to suck your life. But Molbrook, I don't know where that is. Oh, but Molbrook having Molbrook's hand right now is the Book of the Dead! So here, you can have it.
No.
Yes, she just casually forgot she had the Book of the Dead right in her hands. Sound familiar?
I don't have words for it. What?
Okay, do I want to know?
It's not. She's a sleep talker, good to know.
Yes she is. So her lines in the second game I tend to find a bit more amusing. Oh sorry, spoiler, she appears in the second game.
I mean, she seems to be one of the more interesting characters in the game, so I kind of assumed they'd not waste that.
Yeah. So yeah, now we can just go kill Anubis. Admittedly, I am being a bit reckless about it. Oh, that was easier than I expected. And here we have the Serpent Staff. Do you remember what that was useful for? If not, then I don't blame you because it's been a while.
No, I don't.
Items that are better used than not. It's me, some treasures aren't real helpful till you actually put them to use. Yeah. Really? Really? No shit! Oh, what? It's me! Isn't it strange how I know how your adventures are going? I can see through everything. Show me anything rare and unfamiliar. If you find an item you're not quite sure about, bring it to me. If I know anything about it, I'll tell you. That's basically just a cue to come back here with the stuff equipped. So you made it. Now hurry up and go buy a newfangled laptop and let me have a turn on it. Wait, it? Yeah. That's the other line. Oh, so you came across the Serpent Staff. There's a monster called Argos near the altar on the edge of the village. We need to make an offering to the shrine, but that monster sent away and we can't take it down without the Serpent Staff. Now you remember?
Oh, the big eyeball thing.
Yeah.
All the eyes.
Like, from way back at the beginning of the game.
I should probably equip the shield so I don't accidentally flare people. Also, before I actually completely forget about it. Oh. Well, I'll get enough soon enough at least. Hurt this guy.
Good thing he's not that tough.
Well, yeah, he keeps walking forward and pushes you out of the screen if you don't kill him quickly enough.
So. Yeah, I know.
So you need to be able to quick him, kill him fast.
That was the point.
And now we get here. And obtain a feather. Yeah, it's the W.
Hey!
Yay! It's me! You took the treasure from our villager's shrine, didn't you? Thief! That was an offering by the villagers! Oh well, the feather has a strange power. The jump button, while you're jumping, it will let you jump twice. You'll be able to jump further and higher than before. And even if you fall from a high place, you might be able to get by with a mini jump. You're going to have to pay for your TBD one day. Yay, double jump! I miss you so much! It's so nice to finally have it back. Oh. Now give me my upgrade. Thank you. Alright, now there's quite a few more things we can do now.
Yeah,
I'm not even sure where to begin. Oh, I know. Let's go to the Mausoleum of the Giants. To the Graveyard of the Giants. I'm stupid. Could have just gone this way. Down. You know what? I do not care for you. Oh, oh well. Also, we can. Well, we can do this puzzle now for one. It's a bit of an annoying puzzle. Because you need to
most
get...
block puzzles are.
Oh damn it, I messed it up.
Well done!
Oh well. I can do the far more important job of getting this thing open. Bust your fins! Ow, worth it. Feature Development Company. It's a software. You know what it does? It does this. Rather useful, don't you think?
Just a wee bit.
And of course, we get a mail about it. It's me, I'm Bor, so I'm playing my favorite Nigoro game. Well, you got some newer games on your laptop too. If you have one, why don't have, let me try it.
Really?
Really useful, old man.
It's like not even something useful to say about it. Actually, now that I think about it, since we have double jump, we can just do this the easy way. I'll push on this one first. Yeah, there's no actual secret switch to block the laser, you just literally block the laser. Oh. I'm bad. This is nothing new. But yeah, that opened this. Which would be very helpful except we actually can't activate that. You know.
Manorito.
Yeah. Oh well. We got something useful regardless. Let's see, what else can we do? There's a few places. Yeah, I do not care for you. Let's get over here because with double jump we should actually be able to get up. Even though I'm pretty sure that's not the way we're supposed to get there.
It's a little exploration.
Yeah, sure. That's better. I can't really go on that yet. Can't actually go. Like, can we just go down there? No. Did they say something? Oh, yeah, that. Yeah, I'm just gonna go. What did you have to say? Skanda, a large clay doll, the one who holds the golden key, which soars through the skies. Remember that tablet about the name that means unnamed?
Vaguely.
This is where we're supposed to spell it. I do not remember which tiles I'm supposed to face.
Oh, what fun!
Technically, you can technically just... chase it. Does require you to, you know, come back. I don't think there actually is a way up without getting the main entrance, so I guess we're not using it then.
Well.
Let's see. To the right of the graveyard was the Twin Labyrinths. Why am I here again? Oh, whatever. Alright! We might have the right seal for the thing in the... What's the word again? In the Inferno Cave. So let's check on that. We need to climb back up, well, you know, details. Especially when we can just do double jump now. That was it again. Oh yeah, that game I can't afford. So like most games, really. Activated now. Was there something important here? He just tells me exactly what I wanted to know. That there's a weapon. Right there. And now you know what this meant.
No kidding.
This might take me a couple tries, just so you know.
Good luck!
Thank you, I knew it. Didn't need you making it even harder, game. What? I was holding up. Ah. Yeah, you can just crush them with the logs. I do not remember the pattern for that very well. I know that mine insists on... Oh! I should have just jumped off. Technically, if you're super good, like speedrunner good, you can just jump at the exact right time and not even have to use the grappling claw.
But that's not us.
Indeed. This is me. Falling down the pit over and over again. Far down. guess I should just jump at this one. Okay. If I actually do it the careful way, I should be able to do it more easily. There we go. And this is not actually a bad puzzle. This is the real puzzle of this area.
You can't hurt that one.
I can if I hit him in the head.
He is not gonna make that easy for you.
No, no, he's not. Okay.
Listen, he just wanted to assert some dominance over you.
Yep, as expected. That is the real issue of the thing. There. Oh, come on. That's fair. Hopefully, if we do it the careful way from the get-go, we might actually have the HP to live through that guy. Much better. So I just realized there's a... a tablet up there. Oh, also, the four philosophers have turned to stone. They continue to protect their homes. Well, that doesn't exactly say much. Pointed to the right, and right it shall go. Pointed to the left, and left it shall go. Heard just once, and it shall never reach thy hands. Okay, technically a puzzle you can actually fail if... permanently fail if you save after failing it at least.
You know, turning your back to the enemy is usually not to your benefit.
No shit.
And yet you consistently do it.
I mean, the shield doesn't actually block those things. And I'm apparently really bad at dodging at the right time for those rocks. I'm gonna save before trying this puzzle, because that is the puzzle you can fail to complete.
I have a good idea.
I'm also gonna heal. At least Pazuzu stays killed. Very important.
Yeah.
And this is really a weapon I don't want to miss. I mean, it's optional, but I still don't want to miss it. Especially since I'm trying to actually show this off. Okay, I'm getting better at that jump, that's good. And that one. Yeah, can you tell it has been quite a while since I last played La Mulana before this?
I mean, I had my suspicions.
Especially the first one, the mobility in the second is so much better. So I just realized something else. There's a door down there.
So there is.
This place was created by the giants as a place for launching the tower with hot water. But the tower failed to fly and this land was abandoned as a result. Thus, this land does not suffer divine retribution. You notice how there's basically not a single eye in this?
Yeah, not even mention it.
Yeah, not even here. Of course, the trap Mortal makes up for it.
Well.
And you need to write those.
Hold on.
I do kinda wish they'd made some kind of shortcut up there once you actually, you know. Oh well, can't be helped. The chain whip. It replaces the normal whip.
Hmm.
Also has this nicely different sound effect. And does more damage.
Yeah, kind of important, that last part.
Yeah, you know. I'm gonna go save immediately. I'm gonna check on something real quick. Also, I am going to not have the pistol equipped. Think about is not ready yet, so yeah. I hope you'll have fun. And next time, well, we have quite a few ideas to check on, don't we?
Indeed.
And I think I've decided on which one. But for now, I hope you'll have
fun. Boy.
And I'll see you next time. Bye.